place between midnight and 1 a.m. Events occur in real time.
I'm not worried about it. I don't think it's any money anyway. You know how it's going lately.
Yeah, I sure do.
Thank you. Okay, go ahead and tell us what you had out here tonight.
If you could start with your name and agency first, and maybe spell your last name.
Very good. My name's Sergeant Crye. I'm with the Sacramento Police Department. Last name spelled C-R-Y-E. We were called to the scene here at 135 hours by the witnesses, who are the residents, who said they heard the sound of screeching tires. Then they heard the sound of a large crash. They came outside. They saw the vehicle, which had impacted a parked vehicle on the side of the road and had gone onto the front yard of a residence and come to a stop. They also saw the taillights of the vehicle leaving the scene. The three occupants of the vehicle, who are juveniles, two of them were in critical condition at the time. The other one was up and talking. The two occupants that were critical were transported to the hospital, and that's where they are at this time.
Is there any indications of street racing in this instance?
At this time, we don't know. Based on the witness statement, we know that another vehicle was seen possibly leaving the scene. Whether or not it was involved with this vehicle or just a driver-by, we do not know at this time. There's still an investigation ongoing.
I saw several little Honda race-type vehicles come over here right after the accident. Were those friends of the driver that crashed, or do you have any knowledge of that?
At this time, I believe those were friends. There was quite a few people that showed up after the incident that apparently recognized the vehicle and assumed that it was their friends that were driving.
And where's your investigation go from here?
Right now, we have traffic units on scene. They're doing the investigation, and we are waiting to see on the condition of the two injured occupants at this time.
Sergeant, in various areas of Sacramento, we've been having problems with street racing. Have there been any reports of that here in this area?
Specifically in this area, no. There are reports frequently regarding drag racing, but as far as tonight, I haven't had any reports of drag racing in the pocket area.
Okay, could you say your name and spell your last name for me one more time?
Again, Sergeant Crye, and my last name is spelled C-R-Y-E.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
Sergeant.
right over. Please. Right now. Hands over. Help.
Thank you. lot of days?
Yeah.
Officer. About 10 after 5 this evening, we got a report of it.
Start over for me.
All right. Captain Dave Witt, WHITT, Sacramento Fire Department, Public Information Officer. At about 10 after 5 this evening, we received a report of an outbuilding on fire in the back of a residence. Firefighters responding to the incident saw a large column of black smoke just leaving the fire stations from the relative areas that they're coming from. They first got on scene, they saw that the shed was indeed well involved. It was exposing a house. The shed had become fully involved, started getting into the house and up into the attic space of one house and into a small apartment complex containing basically three apartments on the other side of the shed. So basically they had three working structure fires when they first arrived here, and they were able to call a second alarm, get additional resources here, and were able to have the fire contained basically to moderate damage to both of the occupied structures, the house and the apartment complex. Of course, it's a very, very hot day. It's temperatures probably in excess of 100 degrees right now, close to it right now. So firefighters took a little bit of a beating here, but they were able to keep the fire from completely destroying either one of the occupancies.
Any ideas of cause?
Right now, it's undetermined. Our investigators are looking into the cause right now. They're interviewing a lot of people and finding out exactly, trying to determine exactly where the fire started. Hopefully we'll be able to wrap that up here shortly and come up with some sort of reasonable determination of what started the fire.
How many displaced persons do we have here?
Displaced persons, right now it looks like we're going to have one family of at least four and probably two more additional adults. We're not exactly sure on the other apartment right now, but probably a minimum of six adults and two or three children.
When a few women get some actions taken care of them right now, what's going on with them?
Well, we have a little bit of smoke inhalation. Some of the people there, they were, you know, kind of quite concerned about their occupancies. They live in modest means, and they're trying to save a lot of their stuff that they have there. They have some animals, they have some personal effects and personal belongings, so they're trying to get those out of there. But a little bit of smoke inhalation, but right now we haven't transported them to the hospital right now. They're just treating them on scene. So far, no one wants to go and get seen at the hospital, so that's a good sign.
How are all you guys doing?
Pretty good, actually. As soon as they get the fire knocked down, they're going to strip off all that clothing, reduce that core temperatures, because the core temperature in a firefighter can get in excess of 100, 304 degrees pretty quickly with all that turnout gear on. So they're stripping it off, replacing it with some lighter weight structural protection and gear so that they can get cooled off and keep cool. They've got a little bit of overhaul to do. Luckily, like I said, for us, we had really good hose line placement on the fire, so we were able to confine the fire to where you see it now.
By 8 o'clock. So you're guaranteed.
I know, you don't have to see, just look to the side. Just look to the side.
I'm sure they're not seeing stars right now.
start with...
Hold on a second. Do you want me to give you what the call came out as, or do you want me to tell you what it really is, ended up being?
What it really ended up being.
Okay, so.
Basically go over out here, South River Road at Road 141. We had a traffic collision, or actually a traffic accident, and we had three patients transported by ground ambulance. There was one fatality on scene, and we're in the process of investigating the accident and basically trying to get the roadway cleared.
You know what I mean?
I'll roll it all up into the...
Do you, drunk driver?
You can do that too.
What do you want?
Well, it's up to you. You can say it's under investigation to protect your butt, like everybody else does. Or you can say that...
I have to say that with all those other ones.
Oh. See, now that's what everybody does up here, is they don't tell anything. They just say it's under investigation. I could ask you separately.
Actually, what I said was, based... given all the statements from everybody else.
I just said spontaneous statements
from the passengers.
Right.
This is what they were saying. I never said what I had.
Witnesses
said. Okay. That's exactly what I said. I never said anything.
Okay.
I just said what witnesses said.
Try and roll it into
so.
One sentence. Highway 160 at Road 141, we had a vehicle accident with three injured parties. We had one fatality on scene, and then may have been a result of alcohol.
Okay.
Let me get you set up here.
Okay, go ahead and tell me what you're responding to out here tonight.
On South River Road at County Road 141, we had a traffic accident involving three injured parties and one fatality.
Was there any cause for this accident? At this time, do you have any knowledge of anything that may have been a contributing factor to this accident?
Right now, it's under investigation of possibly drinking and driving.
That's an accident. Could you roll this all into one sentence? We're going to go with Highway 160.
I know, I screwed it up. I forgot.
That's okay.
I was just like, I forgot.
I can cut it up later.
Good. I hope they really get that other one up. I forgot what I was saying.
Okay. We're gonna take it from the top.
Okay.
Responding to Highway 161.
Okay. Well, Highway South. Oh, is it 160?
Well,
or is it South River Road?
It switches back and forth.
Oh, really?
It's South River Road's fine.
Oh, okay. And that's County Road 141, right?
Correct.
And, okay, and there hasn't been one fatality.
Transported a drowned ambulance.
And possibly involving drinking and driving. Okay.
Okay,
let's try it again. Okay.
Go ahead. What did you respond to this evening?
I responded to a injury, a collision.
Can we call it a collision?
Sorry, you want me to ask an accident? That's right. Okay, sorry. I responded to a accident on South River Road and 141 involving three injured parties and one fatality. The accident occurred. Oh God, I'm really.
And go ahead with what you responded to this evening.
Okay, wait. You wanted me to say a traffic accident on South River Road. That's right. Okay. I responded to a traffic accident on South River Road in 141 that resulted in three injuries with the parties transported by ground ambulance and one fatality. The traffic collision is being investigated for the cause being possibly driving under the influence of alcohol.
And could you state your name and spell your last name?
My name is Officer Taitano, Taitano.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. We have had an auto accident involving extrication. We had one patient that was trapped in the vehicle. We used the jaws of life to get him out, and he was transported by life flight to the UCD Med Center.
How bad was the extrication? I mean, how long did it take you to...
I don't have any idea at this point how long it took us to get him out.
But it was a pretty severe extrication. He was pinned in the front field.
Yeah, he was, you know, it was an extrication. It took us a while to get to it.
Does this heat affect you, your guys when they're out there trying to work hard? It was something about the heat.
Well, there's not a lot you can do. Drink a lot of water and stay hydrated. But, yeah, when they get all their gear on, it's pretty hot for them.
And can you state your name and spell your last
name? Dan Norton, N-O-R-T-O-N.
And one more time, can you go over what your crews found on scene as they arrived?
First unit arrived, reported a person trapped in the one vehicle. Extrication was required. And
can you tell me about the medical transportation?
The patient was transported by life flight.
And could you say your name one more time and spell your last name for me?
Dan Norton, and N-O-R-T-O-N.
That's always the toughest question.
Right.
Possibly the speed, direction, travel, impact, and then possibility of alcohol involvement.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, right now our preliminary investigation has shown that the silver vehicle was northbound on Power Inn Road north of Gerber at approximately 50 miles per hour. The red Mercedes was parked on the right shoulder ahead of it, and for an unknown reason he made a U-turn, attempted to make a U-turn and proceed southbound Power Inn. They obviously collided in the traffic lane. And the driver of the silver vehicle had been drinking. Tests, field sobriety tests were given to him, and it was determined that he was impaired and subsequently was arrested for driving under the influence.
Could you state your name and spell your last name?
Marty Whited, W-H-I-T-E-D.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.